Welcome everyone. In this video, you'll be learning about beginner level excavator training. So the following requirements are based on the information found on the Equipment Operator's Manual and the AHS Safety Manual. These requirements are not based on every excavator. As the operator, it is your responsibility to read the operator's manual for that make and model of excavator. In the following series of videos, you'll be learning about how to properly fill out a THA, where to find the safety information on the equipment, preparing for safe operation of the equipment, the operating of the equipment, how to properly park a piece of equipment, and the shutting down of the engine.
During the THA meeting, it is important that the excavator operator identifies any and all hazards associated with the operation of the equipment. Identifying a spotter, if it is necessary to have one, communicates with the crews working on the ground and any other heavy equipment the process of working around each other, identifies any overhead power lines and underground utilities if it is necessary for the task. All Jordan Foster equipment must have an equipment inspection checklist that is filled out on a daily basis before you start operating that piece of equipment. Any deficiencies that are found on the piece of equipment need to be marked and written down on the checklist, and the operator must sign the sheet. When performing your walk-around inspection, you want to look at the rails to make sure they are in working condition. You want to check your steps to make sure that they're not broken or damaged or missing. You want to inspect your mirrors to make sure they're not damaged, they're not missing, they're not broken, they cannot obstruct the view. You also want to inspect the tracks on the excavator to make sure that there's no missing or broken parts. You want to look at all hoses and connections to make sure that there is no leaks on the equipment. You want to look under your counterweight, cab, and turntable to see if there's any damage or leaks. Inspect the radiators to see if there's any leaks, any coolant that's leaking. You want to inspect the boom and the bucket on the equipment to ensure that there is no hydraulic leaks or damaged hoses, that the bucket is secured correctly, or any other attachment that is used with the excavator, making sure that the bucket's teeth aren't damaged or missing. Once in the cab, you want to make sure that the equipment has a properly functional seatbelt and any emergency brakes are taken off or set. You want to make sure that the equipment's horn works and that the backup alarm is functioning. Now that the inspection is complete, you are ready to operate that equipment. It is important that you know the controls on that piece of equipment. Different models might not have the same controls. If there is ever a control or function that you are not aware of, always look at your operator's manual for any questions you may have regarding that equipment. Operator's manuals have all the information you will need, from the controls to how much the machine can lift. And it is important that the operator is able to find that information.